Hey everybody, welcome back to another episode of Minecraft on the KingKraft server. I'm currently running down my nether tunnel. I had forgotten how long the run was. I believe I've timed it about 8 minutes so far. Which doesn't sound like a lot. You know, 8's a little number. But 8 minutes of this is, It can be rough. So definitely either need to widen it enough for a horse or get a rail track in, because this is nuts. I remember this mushroom. I'm getting close. But yeah, I'll catch up with you guys when I get back to my base. Just under 10 and a half minutes. That's right. Why did I come out this far? I don't really know. Actually, that's not true. Come on, get on ground. I was looking for a jungle next to a mesa, which I found using a mist with our map seed, and unfortunately this was the closest one. And good, it's raining. Is that rain? It's rain. Beautiful. And it's nighttime. Great. We're not actually working out here today. So I have all of this guardian stuff from our sea temple farm, which is probably one of the most impressive builds on the server right now, and we need to go check it out at some point. But I wanted to bring this stuff over and get it in my storage room so it wasn't cluttering up my chest in my house at spawn. And also wanted to check and make sure everything was still here. Yeah, just still so much to do out here. It's almost overwhelming. That might be why I haven't come back out here. Let's see. Where did I have the seed temple stuff? This was nether stuff. Cobblestone. Wool. Maybe here? Might be the only empty spot left. So that's clay, dirt. What was this going to be? Probably be a good spot for sand. And all these are wood. So yeah, I think that spot over there is going to be the only spot I got left. I don't have any chests. I do have chests. So let's do that. And which block is most representative of sea temple? It's probably prismarine. Yep. So let's do that in there. This stuff in here, and I'll put those in there too. And sea lanterns. Wow, that was terrible. What happened there? Love it. But today we're actually going to head over to the Harvest Moon area, which I think I've got half functional. And I think we're just gonna try and run through what would be a day in that game and see what we can do. It's probably gonna need some balancing work, and it's probably gonna need a lot of work. But I figured we'd give it a shot. So, oh yeah, I have a chicken farm. It would probably be a lot more effective if I spent any time over here. But yeah, we're going to head over to the farming area and play there for a while. So see you in a bit. Alright, so we are back at the Harvest Moon area. We'll just quickly go over the stuff that we've added since the last time we were over here. So in the actual game, when you first move into the farm, the field's all overgrown and you have to kind of clear it out as you want to use it. So we've added that. I've started this path here with the bricks, which is kicking my butt with that clay harvesting. So that's going to be an ongoing thing probably, because I want to use bricks for the pathway throughout the entire map. We finished the chicken farm last time. But this is new. This is the cow and sheep farm. Which I think in the game is called Yodel Ranch. I'll stick a sign up somewhere. But so we have the chicken farm, we can buy chickens, and now we have a place where we can buy sheep and cows eventually. Probably won't get to that today. Wow, word, drip, fart, death. Yeah, so I think our goal for today is to plant and harvest enough stuff to get a chicken for the farm. Because the real money makers in this game are the stuff you can harvest daily. The crops and stuff you can make a lot of money off of, but you have to wait for them to grow. Just like in this game. How about that? So, what we're going to do is kind of treat this like basic day one in Harvest Moon. So, and in Harvest Moon, the tools don't degrade, so we're just going to have to keep like a steady inventory of tools in here. And you also start out with a little bit of money. So let's take our money, go up here to the market, see what we can buy. This isn't the actual market. There's a lot of the map left to build, so yeah, we'll have to get to that eventually. There will eventually be an actual market. So these are the prices for the seeds right now. So let's kind of make it, just keep it simple. We'll buy 20 wheat and 20 potatoes. So that'll be 40, and we'll have 24 left. And yeah, let's just do that for right now. 20 potatoes and 20 wheat. All right, so we got our seeds, and I didn't put the fertilizer in here. I had to make another book because I accidentally threw the first one away. But let's say fertilizer will be 2 for 1. The first number is the thing, and the second number is how many tokens. Okay, so we spent 40. Let's put that in here, and now we have 24 left. So that would be, let's just spend 20 to make it easy on ourselves. So let's get 40 fertilizer. And leave the book here. Mm-hmm. Alright, and I guess I didn't time this very well. In the game you have till sunset to, stick the rest back down. This is a... It's supposed to be a beehive where you can collect honey from each day. So let's stick that in there. These aren't mine. These are what I get to take based on what I drop off during the day. And there's a bed. Do I even have a bed out here, actually? Whatever. We'll work through the night. We'll pretend it's still day. So first thing we need to do is clear out a little bit of area so we can start planting stuff. Yeah, I was just thinking the cobble I'm using here is the same as the tokens, but it's this stuff is named so it won't get mixed up. See? Pretty. So the grass represents like weeds. And in the game, they regrow every so often. I don't know if I'll include that mechanic in it or not. But the wood, you actually get to keep, and you can use that towards separating parts of the field off. You can make like animal pens, or just separating your crops. So you can store that. The rocks, I think you can store those too, but I'm not sure. Actually, I think they don't actually break, so you can just move them around the field, or you can throw them in the river and that gets rid of them. And I kept my bow on me for situations like this, and I'm a terrible shot. No, and this is going to be the rest of the game now. Come on. Okay. And that's it. No more. Okay. So we got this little area cleared out now, so we have a little bit of room to start planting stuff, so let's just go ahead and start planting. I gotta be quick about it. That's one of the things with, you can't really keep it hydrated the way it's set up right now. So, gotta be quick. And we'll just do another two here. Just to get those in the ground, we'll clear this out. Get rid of these bushes. And we'll plant our wheat. Get that on the hotbar. Oh, okay. The, what is this called? Crap. Something dirt. Right? But you have to till it twice to get it to tilled soil. I haven't thought about that. In hindsight, using this soil probably wasn't the best idea. But originally all this was supposed to be grass, but it would have just been a lot harder to keep up with, I think. So I just did it with clay. Alright, so we got our crops planted. How many tokens do we have left over? We have 4 tokens right now. So let's use our fertilizer. Both of these are actually... Hey! What in the heck? You're not in this game! Okay. We'll have to do a little bit of blocking off better. Which I think if we just did something right here, it would be completely surrounded by fences and lit up, so whatever. Eventually we'll get to it. So let's use our fertilizer and just go ahead and grow up some of these. And this may need some balancing at some point. I don't know if it's going to be overpowered as far as the fertilizer goes or not. So let's go ahead and harvest these. We will replant. Guess I should do that pretty quick after I harvest since it's not hydrated. Alright, so we can deposit that. And that'll get us... So that... I have the presses in here, I think. Where did it go? Okay. Not there. Okay, so potatoes are 8 for 1. And the honey is 1 for 1. So, what is 35? Oh, wow, I can't do math. Don't make me do math. Wait. Alright, so that is 5, right? Yeah. And then we'll keep these 3 here for the next shipment. And just thinking about it now, how much do the animals actually cost? I may have made this a little bit more grindy than I meant to. Okay. So we have, what do we have now? We have 9. So yeah, it's definitely a lot more grindy than I planned for it to be, but I think that's gonna be okay. Because this is one of the least used mechanics in the game. When people set up farms, they want to set up something that's, you know, quick and automatic, and they don't have to do anything with it. That's, well, pretend that doesn't exist. And that's no fun. Maybe we'll set up something where logging is a business. Because we don't have the mine set up yet. That's one of the big ways to make money. So yeah, I think that would be cool. Because in the actual map, on the other side of this river, there's like a forest where there's a lumberjack. And you can pay him to build stuff. And upgrade your buildings and stuff like that. So we could just turn that into like a forestry area. Might be something to look into. And apart from using this to make enclosures in your field here, one of the main uses for wood is as you sort of pay for your upgrades with wood, you provide the supplies. So all the buildings we have here are already the upgraded versions, just because I didn't want to, well, not because I didn't want to, but I thought it would be easier to figure out how big the space needed to be with the upgraded buildings, right? So yeah, that might be something cool we can do. And actually, one of the other money makers that I have for this game, and why we have wooden swords to make it a little bit more of a challenge, is mob drops are actually worth stuff. Please don't go play with the creeper. Don't. Oh crap, I have hostile mob sounds turned off. That could be bad. It is bad. I'm just gonna kill this guy. Alright, let's go add this to the pot and see how much that gives us. It's not gonna be enough for a chicken, but it'll be a little something else. And actually, while I'm thinking about it, let me turn mobs back up. Okay. Chicken. Alright, so we got a bone and 2 gunpowder. And we won't be allowed to turn the bones into fertilizer. I don't think. Not for now, anyways. Alright. Bone 1-for-1 and gunpowder 1-for-1. So that's an extra 3 tokens. Toss those in there and give me those. Now we're up to 12. Go ahead and stick that in our personal chest. So you can kind of see the mechanics here. We kind of did a little bit of this the first time we looked at it, but we're gonna kind of continue this, and I'm gonna do a little bit of this off camera so we can get some worked up. I don't think I'm going to allow myself, when I harvest something, I get more than one usually. I don't think I'm going to allow myself to plant the ones I harvest. Like, I can replant, but I don't want to use the extra ones I get. I'll have to ship those. So let me play a little bit of this. Goodness gracious. Let me play a little bit of this off of camera, and we will check up with my progress momentarily. Alright, so we've done a little bit more farming here. You see I've added another few spaces of potatoes. We used up, not potatoes, potatoes and wheat. We used up the rest of the tokens I had on that. I emptied this out, started a new day, that's what I've harvested for potatoes, and got my sugar from today. So something I've added, we talked about the forestry stuff just a little bit ago, so I've added that in here to kind of make it, it might be a little bit OP right now. We'll have to see. If I do keep those prices, I think we'll put some limitations on it so that we can only do it every 2 or 3 days. But this is going to allow us to get a little bit of money up front and let us get that chicken. So let's go ahead and harvest this out. Yeah, we'll go ahead and build these. Alright. Oop! No. That's okay. Mulligan. So let's put this in here. So what's that gonna be? Oops, reverse that. So that's 3 and then 16 times, I think it was 4, is crap. It's 64. Okay. Okay. Oh, wow, I can't type. K button. Bye. So that's gonna be 3 and 64. Yeah. And we'll go ahead and throw this stuff out. I've just been hucking it over the fence here. All right, so we can now actually need a way to get him back here. The chicken I'm going to buy. It's the 50 we're gonna need for the chicken. I just need to borrow a seed from somewhere. I'll put it back. I haven't really thought this part through. That's fine. Seed, please. Seed, please. Thank you. Need to think of a name for the chicken. I like to name all my animals. Zombie. Alright, so I forget if I left a chest or something in here. We'll just leave it here to despawn. Hooray. Yep. Alright, need a chicken. You. I'm gonna try and push one out so I don't. Oh. Alright, we're taking you home. Come on, buddy. This one just wanted to leave with me. Let's go. So as we're walking backwards, looking deep into his eyes, be thinking of a name. Oops, I need to eat real quick. Oh, don't shoot. Don't you shoot my chicken. Or me, preferably. Ouch. Boy, these wooden swords leave a lot to be desired. Come on. Come on, buddy. On the way. Can I farm him? Which I technically can, I guess. So we put the chickens in the little chicken coop we got. And then there's a few things we can do once they're in here. And we'll kind of talk about that. Again, mentioned it briefly last time we were out here, but we'll go into it in a little bit more detail. So we have our chicken. Need to put that back. So the chicken can lay eggs, right? We can take those eggs and we can ship them. There's a price in the book. I forget what it is exactly. Or these are like incubation areas. So we can take the egg. If we don't want to buy another chicken, we can put it in the incubator. Leave it here for like 3 or 4 days and then try and hatch it. And if we get a new chicken, it cost us a little bit of time for waiting, but it didn't cost us any more money and we got another chicken. So that's kind of a cool mechanic that's in the original game. Actually, you don't have a chance of not hatching a chicken. You just get a new chicken. But that's how we're going to do it out here. And we may shorten the time since there's a chance that you won't get a new chicken. Maybe every other day we'll be able to try that. But yeah, no eggs so far, but we have a little guy out here to start pooping out some eggs for me. Crops are so slow. We already did that. We got 4 in the chest for next shipment. And so yeah, you can kind of see the general mechanics of how this stuff works out here. Please die. No, I'm not dealing with you. And you may notice that there's stuff in the actual market. No, I can sell that. Right? Yeah, I killed something somewhere. We'll go to baby. But this actually takes separate farms to keep the marketplace stocked, which is what I've got down here. Just a little simple setup. But if you ever wanted to overcomplicate your farming process, I highly recommend this. It's I think it's a lot of fun. Something different to do. And something that, you know, it takes some time and some attention, and some people are looking for something like that. So yeah, we'll probably do a video out here every couple of weeks. I'll be playing some in between then, but those will be more like update videos and show you the different stages of the game. Need to add a blacksmith, That's a way for you to upgrade your tools, and we'll probably add swords in there. Need to add the mine so we can add the blacksmith, because you need materials from the mine to upgrade your tools. Need to finish the rest of the map, and we'll probably do that procedurally as we progress through the game. But yeah, this is gonna be fun, and I'm going to enjoy it, and I'll try to keep it interesting for you guys. I know it's probably a little less interesting to watch, but yeah, it's gonna be fun. So just, that's it. That just, yes, okay. Yeah, this is Burrito King, signing off from the KingKraft server. Until next time, goodbye.